Blast advisory written on Agatha. So Agatha is now basically a remnant low. In fact, it looks like it's already moved into the Southwest Gulf. I want you to notice all of this rain that's being pushed off to the east. That's because we've got really strong winds aloft. So let's look at what's happening. Here it is. And you can see that circulation, can't you? It's a broad area of low pressure. And to me, I had to put the low in so you could see. It looks like the center right about in here. You can see that broad circulation. Certainly, the water is warm, so you've got the potential for development, but it takes so much more. So this is the area that the Hurricane Center is highlighting, where we have that potential for development. It's about a 70% chance. Here's Southeast Louisiana. We're nowhere near it. So let's investigate what's happening. One, you can see how we've got this onshore flow by us, and you're going, well, why isn't that going to steer the system to the north? Look at this. We have got really strong winds out of the west aloft, so that's going to help take the system off to the east. So now we're looking at what we call wind shear. These winds in here are about 50, 60 miles per hour. That's not conducive to development. We've got an upper level load that's off the east coast. That's what's giving us our north wind, and that's protecting us. This system is not coming our way. So we look at the water temperature. Sure, it's warm. We're in the upper 80s. This is where you've got the warmest, deepest water. It's what we call heat potential. And the system is forecast to possibly develop just across the Yucatan Channel. So I look at the global forecast models. You know, the hurricane models really aren't any good until the system develops, because they tend to think it's already developed. So you look at the global forecast models. The GFS, the global forecast model, has been the best over the past few years. So this is Thursday, a broad low in the Southwest Gulf. Now we're going into Friday, a broad low over the Yucatan Channel, that heavier rain over Cuba. Remember, you've got that strong west wind. And now we're going into Sunday, a little low. This is near the Florida Keys. You still have a broad low in the Yucatan Channel. Does this look like development? Not so much. And then it scoots off to the northeast. Now, the European model, which has not been as good recently, is showing more development. So this is Thursday, broad low over the Yucatan Channel. And then look at how it moves into the Southeast Gulf. This is Friday night, heavy rain moving into Florida. Kind of looks like a depression. And now it's moving over Florida with heavy rain, more of the rain Saturday afternoon offshore. Then it moves into the Atlantic, and that's when it kind of gets its act together. So what about Southeast Louisiana and South Mississippi this week and into next week? You're looking good. Pass a good time, right? Here comes a cold front moving our way. It's going to get kind of close. We do have scattered rain, strongest storm up here by Franklinton, had 44 hundredths of an inch of rain at the airport. And then as you go into the evening, the weather is cooperating. So our forecast, near 90 tomorrow, the better chance of rain Thursday night. And then look, folks, we're getting hot and humid with a slight chance of rain daily.
All right, Margaret.